We are going to learn about how you can place all the views within your sheet and how you can create your sheet for printout. So let's look into that. So we have our project ready, and after that, what you have to do is within this project browser, come to this sheet option, and there you right click on it and go for this new sheet. There is another process to create a new sheet. Go into this View tab, and within this Sheet Composition panel, there is the option Sheet. So you can choose any one option for creating a new sheet. So let's go with this option. And you have to choose one title block. So this will define the page size. So you can load one from the library itself. So if you are choosing if you are working with metric template, so then come to this one. And if you are working with imperial unit, so then come to this folder. So as I am working with metric, so I'll choose this folder. And within that we have this annotation, and here we will select. We will choose not only that. Let me yes. So here we have this title block folder. Within this English, we have this title block folder. So we'll select like if we need A4 one, so we will select this. If we need A3, we can select this. Okay. So let's go with this A3, or you can choose any option, any one option. So let's go with this A3, and this is right now loaded, and select this and click on OK, and that page will be opened. And you can also create this kind of families by yourself also. So you know how to create a new family, so go to this new and family, and there you have to choose the right family template. So like within this English, you will have this title block, and with the default one you can start with, or else what you can do if you are creating your own size and everything you are creating by yourself, then you can go with this new size, and there you will be defining the new size and each and everything from the title block, and within the title block all the titles, all the labels, so that you can do. So let's go with that, or else you can choose any default shape or size. So let's go with this new metric, and let's click on open. And here as well, you can see that this is the boundary you have created. So you can change this. Okay. So this is right now this. So you can change this. Okay. So let's increase this, and also let's increase this. Okay, and you can remove this one, this dimensions. So let's remove this, delete, and come to this create, and here you have this line option, and you can start creating your title block, and next create the table you need. And there you have to place all the labels after creating your diagram for the title block. Then come to create, and there you have this label option. And you will place one label, like let me place one label here, like scale. Okay, so let me place, let me find out if there is any scale. Yes, so this one is present. So this will be your parameter, and this value can be changed. So right now this is the sample value, and it will be no prefix and suffix, and let's place, click on OK. All right, so this is the label you have placed right now, and this way you will place each and every label. So you already aware of attribute in AutoCAD, so it is the same thing. It is kind of similar to attribute, this one. So after selecting it, if you need to change the text size, so there you can change the text size. So for that, there you have this two option to type within this system family. You can create your own by this duplicating option. So let's create with 3 mm. All right, let's create 3 mm, click on OK, and let's change this to 3 mm, and anything like color, anything you want to change, so that you also can change. So I'm only changing the text size, and let's click on OK, and this one I am having. Okay, so and this value is variable. So this there you need to place one thing that that will always highlight that which value you are mentioning over there. So for that, text, you will place text. So this, okay, now, so this this value, this text will also will always be fixed, but the value for the scale will be variable. So that's why we have created this one with label. So next, again, if you want to change the scale text size, so there you can change. Okay, so let's go this duplicate, and here also create 3 mm, and click on OK, and let's change the 3 mm, and click on OK, and there you can see. Okay, so if you want to change this tab size, so that you can change it like this one with this tab size, or you can increase with this grip points as well. So let's change it to, okay, so let's click this also, and let's position. All right, fine. So this way you can place all the things. Okay, this one you can place all the things you can place. So you all are aware of how you can create this title block already. So this how you will be placing all your label and text, and if you need to place any symbol, so that you can place as well with this symbol. And with this line, you will create your page boundary area. So if you want to place any symbol, like let me see that there is any symbols, come to annotation, and choose one symbol from this list. So let's see, like this north arrow. Okay, this things, if you need revision tags, okay, this symbol, if you need any symbol, so that you can load first. Okay, so let's choose the north arrow. Okay, so let's choose this one and click on open, and there you can place this. Okay, and there you can rotate this as well. Is the north arrow. So this symbol also you can place, and all the labels you can place. And after that, what you will do, you will save this first. Come to this save, and let's give this a name. Page size 410. 410. by 305 mm. This name we will save it, and in the backup option maximum 1, and let's save it in desktop. And now what I will do, we will load into our project. So let's just load into this project, and it's not possible within this view, obviously that cannot be loaded within this. So for that we already have this sheet option, so we will create a new sheet, and for that we will now we will choose this page, right, and click on OK. And now here you can see that this is the value, and this is created over there, this is placed over there, okay, and there you can change this value, okay, and you can come to this edit label option, okay, and you can change the sample values, okay, and so same like that you have within this, okay. So like if you select this one, so here you can see that this project name, if you come to this, so this one here you can see, or within this also you have all this list of this sheet name, sheet number, sheet issue date, so these are already there. So you can change the names over there, like okay, so this one is named, and this sheet name you can give it like 2D, elevations only. Yes. So now here you can see that this sheet number is A101, and the name for the sheet is 2D elevations. So this is how you will create your sheet, and after that you can change everything. You can place your logo and everything. This is placed, so you can edit the existing family as well. So select this title block family, and then go to this edit family. And there also you can check like this image is placed, okay. You can simply place your image by this insert tab. Go to this insert tab, and there you have this import image option, and you can easily place, and you can manipulate your image and place it on the proper place, and you can change this label. So this is the label, and select this and come to this edit label, and you can create tables like this, and you can create your own sheet like that, or if you want to modify the existing sheet, so that you can come to this edit family options, okay, and there you have. Now after creating your sheet, what you have to do is you have to place all your views. So how you can do that? So for that, what you can do is very simple process, that within this project browser, we have all our plan views, 3D views, elevations, our rendering. Yesterday, in the yesterday's class, we have seen that how we can create our rendering views, walkthroughs. So those views, rendering views also we can add. We can add our schedule cells also. So from the project browser, what we have to do is we select the view which we want to place within our sheet. So just select that and hold and drag it to the sheet, and then you just have to place it within your sheet, okay. So now here you can see that this is too big, right, so that cannot be placed properly. But here you can see that this plan is the plan can be placed within this sheet, but the boundary for this plan, within this plan view, that is too much big, right? So This is because of this elevation cameras. These so according to those elevation cameras, it will create the boundary. Okay, so outside of those elevation cameras, you will have the view boundary. Okay, so you can if you move the position for this, so there you can change it. So for that, let me show you like this. If you place like this. Okay, now you come to your sheet and there you see this. Now you are having this, right? And now what you can do is you can place it and there you have. Now also what you can do is like if you come to this level one and there you can change the scale as well. So like this you can change the scale so that will reflect over there, or else you don't have to switch to that view. Within this also you can, if you select this viewport, your level one viewport, and if you come to this properties palette, and there you can change this view scale like this, and here you can see. All right, okay. Now this is the label for your viewport. Okay, viewport title you can say. This one, so right now this one is placed so low, so we have to change the position for of this. We have to change the position of this viewport title. So for that, you just select this one and you simply can drag it and place it. Okay, so this is the proper place. Now you can also see that the length of this viewport title is so big. It's going beyond this page. So for that, what you have to do, you have to select the viewport itself. You select the viewport itself, then you will have this grip points for the title lines. Then you can change. All right, now you have it. And if you don't need the title, so what you can do is come to this type selector. And there you can go with this no title or title no line. You don't need line. You just need title. So that you can select. If you select no title, so there will be no title. You can select title with line. Okay, so whatever is you need, you can select within this type selector. Now this way you can place all your views. And we have another option. If you come to this view tab, so there you have this view. This view option, place view. And if you come to this, and from the list you have to select. So now let me select east elevation. Okay, east elevation, and come to this add view to sheet. Now you can add. Now here you can see that Revit is so intelligent that showing me that if you want to match the viewport title line, so that it's aligning, so it's showing you that line. But if you want to match with the what I can say, the elevation, that if you want to match, so then what you have to do is you have to place like this, or it will show you like this. And as because it's combining with this within this view, so what we have to do is you can activate this view if you want to change the boundary. So you activate this view, and here itself you can do the changes. You don't have to switch within the level one. So here you can change these positions. Okay. Now double click outside of this boundary. So it's like this similar in AutoCAD, activating the model space and paper space. All right, so now What you can do is you can place this one. And so this is coming accordingly, according to the level length. So if you change this and double click outside of the page, and now here you can see that this is the boundary right now. Okay, and now here you can see this one dotted line is coming, so it will match the elevation. Okay, so now it's according to this this side, this will match this lines, your projection line, that is, so that you can match. So when you are placing like this, there you can see one two dotted line is being highlighted, and that is the projection line, and there you can place properly. Okay, and now about this, so you place it over there, or you can place it over there, and after this you can change the placement. And that is the view you have placed. Okay, so this how you will be placing all your views within the sheet. We have another option to align. Okay, if you want to align it according to the graph, so that we also have. So for that, we have this guide grid option. This option will be provided by Revit. So if you select this guide grid and you create one guide grid, so let's select 405 by, sorry, 410, 410 by 305. So you can easily identify that this guide grid is for particular this page. So click on OK. And now here you can see that this default grid is right now created. So if you want to change this spacings, right? This spacings you want to change. So for that, you just select this guide grid, and you can come to this guide spacing within this properties palette, and there you can change this. Like let's go with this 15 mm, and there you have, and with this grip points you can change the boundary like this, so it will properly grip the boundary. You will understand that it has been aligned now. What you can do is you can snap to this grid line, this like this. You can come to this and just zoom, and now you can place it like that. So here you can see that it's matching. So now you can place it like that in this grid, like this way. So for that, you just zoom it a bit, and then when you place it, it will align. And similar way, you can do this for this one. So when you are selecting, make sure that you are selecting this viewport title line, and then click, hold and drag, and now here you can see that it's matching. Okay, so now it's placed, and also you can place you can align this level lines with the grid lines as well. So for that, what you can do is you can come to this move option, and with this point to this point you can match like that, you can match, and this one you can align with this one. Okay, so like this you can place it. or else you can change the positions. Again, you can change the positions. All right, so this is how you can also align with the grid. Okay, and after that, what you can do is select this page and select this grid line. To select it, press tab so that you select this guide grid option, and you can change this options again. You can change the name again. Okay, and this is your sheet, and there you have if you need to change any options there, so that you can do changes, and you can create duplicate and also modify something, and from here also you can load it. Okay, and here you have this guide grid option, and you can create again, you can create one new guide grid, and you can apply it. Okay, so for different page, you can create more guide grids. All right, so let's see there is anything to change. No, nothing to change. And now let me show you one more thing, that is if you come to this level one, and here you can see that this one right now is have the name because you have placed this elevation. Okay, but you haven't placed these elevations within the sheet. So this name, this is the second view within this sheet. This name refers that this elevation, east side elevation, is the second view within this page or within this A101 sheet. Okay, so right now let me place A1 within this A102. So let me place one view. So let's place like elevation waist, add view to sheet, and let's add this view to this sheet. And now if you come to this, and there you can see that this is the first view for this sheet. This elevation is the first view for this sheet. So if you create like section as well, okay, and place this section, and there you see that these are blank right now. Now within this, when you place this section view, when you place this, like you can drag like this, so this is the second view. You can see that this is the second view within this A102, and now when if you come to this, and now you can see that 2102 is filled up. So you cannot fill it by yourself, so it will be automatically filled up. And if you change anything, you can change it after that as well. Okay, so here you can come to this detail number, here you can change it, so it will be reflected to this sheet as well. So this is how you will be placing and controlling your views. Okay, so all right, so that is the option. And yeah, okay, fine. So now let's go for printout. Okay, and so for that you have this option, print, or you can simply press Control P for the option, or you can come to this file, and there you have this print. So from this print, you will have more settings, like you can go for this print. Print is for a single sheet or a particular sheet, and batch print for multi numbers of sheet within a single task, you want to print it out. So for that, you will go with this batch print, and print preview is just a preview before printing it out, you just want to check it and print it up. You set this for the further use, you set it so that you can go with. So let's go with this print option. There we will see everything print setup and everything we will see. And there you go with this Microsoft print to PDF. And if you have your printer connected, you will be selecting your printer name. And for the layout, if it is landscape or portrait, there you can choose. And if you want to change the paper size, so like A3 or A4, there you can go with, and it is landscape, and click on OK. And you want to combine multiple selected views or sheet into a single file, so that is selected right now. And this will be saved within this path, so let me just change it. Let me save it here. Okay, within this Revit, let me just save it as a PDF. So this is the path. And what is your print? Like if you want to print this current window, so for that you can choose, or you want to print some portion, so for that go with, and if you click on OK, so then you can select again, you have to save it. So let me just give it a name, one desktop as well, save it. So let me give it window print and let save. Let's go for save. And let me just check it. Okay, let me just share the screen, and there you can see that this is the print. And let me come again. So here is the shortcut. So this is visible portion of your current window, so that is printed. Okay, and if you choose the current window, so that window will be printed. So we will always go for the selected views or sheet, and then we will specify that sheet. So that sheet will be printed only. And here within this list, what you want to see, so if you want to see the sheets and views, everything, so you can check both. If you don't want to see the views, so you will uncheck. Only this sheet will be visible, and you click on OK. So if you want to save the settings for future, so you can save this. Let me just go with this no option. And for this settings, let's go for the settings. Now this setting is very much important. Here you can see that paper size I have already mentioned within this properties, and that is landscape. Now what is the paper placement, if there is any offset that you want to give. So printer limit or user defined, so you can define XY values. Okay, and you can make it center and zoom. Don't go for this fit to page, go with this zoom and then 100% size. So for that it will be placed within the printable area. And this appearance and raster quality, that is absolutely okay, there is nothing to change. And hidden line views, if you want to remove this any process with this particular process, that you can choose. And let's go with this, click OK, and let's just not save, no. And there is this option is right now done. And yeah, so there is nothing to, and let's click on OK. yes. Okay, so now let's just save this. So this is A101. This is your project name, and you can give your drawing name or the building name you can give. Okay, and then so let's give it Almeda project. And then you can give it like if there is any block, particular block is there, so that you can give. And this is like 2D drawings, so you can give the abbreviations DR. And what is the discipline? That is architecture. And you can give the revision. So this is how you will save it. Let's go with that and click on cancel. And so here you can see this is the total sheet. You have printed just the sheet. Okay. All right, fine. So this is how you will be printing it out. Okay, so this is how you will create your sheet, and you will place all your views within the sheet, and you will be printing it out. Okay, and we also have this title block option, and here also you can create another sheet within this. You can create another sheet from this list. You can choose this one. Okay, like you can make it A3 metric. So place more title blocks. Okay, so this is how you will be creating. You can also place your schedules there. You just have to drag and place there the schedules. Okay, so now let me just create one schedule quickly. So I will create one room schedule. Let's create a room. Yeah, this one room schedule, and let's click on OK. And what you want, room area that you want, and label if you want.
Hello.
Hello. Yes.
Sir, I can't see the screen.
Okay. Sorry. All right. So sorry. Now is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So after doing the printout, you couldn't see, or from when you didn't see it?
After printout, sir.
After the everything. So just let me cover that, which I missed out. So this is the print result. So there you can see that you have printed out just the sheet, just the whole sheet printed out. This is the result. Okay, and you can also place more sheet within this also. So for that you can come to the starting block, and the type which you want to place. It is A1 in this, you can place it. So it is still A101. So also you can create more, you can add more sheets to this. So we will be creating your sheet and placing all the views, and it is waiting for the printout. And printout options are available in the complex toolbar, and there is application menu itself. So you can choose the option and you can have your printouts. Now what I was telling all about. And yeah, so about placing your schedules, right? So let me just quickly create one schedule. I hope this Revit screen is visible, right? Okay. Let's create room schedule and let's choose the things. Let's choose area, and if you want to give the building name, so that will come from the project information, so that you can mention. That's okay, and let's click on OK, and you can see that this is, so building name is not given for this one. If there is any building name, let's put it. Yes, it is. So you can add that. You can add here as well. Okay. Let's hide this one. Okay, right click and right. Okay, so now here you can see that this area we are having right now, and let me just add the total for the area, so you will have the carpet area. So for that, let me come to this formatting option and choose the area and go for this calculate totals and come to the sorting and grouping in this grand totals. Just add totals only and click on OK, and here you will have this. Now come to this come to any sheet, and there you can do is just drag this room schedule, and you can see that this is placed. And after placing this, you're going to break it into two, so you can break it into two like this, and this will be as a single element after breaking it as well. And if you want to join this again, so what I will do is combine this like this way. You can again combine it. Okay, and you can to stretch the area, so you can stretch this area. Okay, so this how you can place your room schedules also, and you can place all your 3D views and other views as well. So I hope you understood this part, and with this architecture is completed. If you have any question regarding this Revit architecture, you can ask me. Hello guys.
Hello.
Yeah, hello. So is this part clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you.